In this model, I will discuss another model for inventory control, the quantity discount model. Previously, we assumed there is no quantity discount, but in this model, we assume there is a quantity discount. To understand what this model is about, let's review back the cost involved in inventory control.
The costs involved for inventory are material costs, ordering costs, holding costs, and stockout costs. Under the EOQ model, we don't consider material costs because we assume there is no quantity discount. We also don't consider stockout costs because we assume there is no stockout. Therefore, the EOQ model only considers ordering costs and holding costs. According to the new model, we still don't consider stockout costs because we assume there is no stockout. But this model assumes there is a quantity discount. It means that there are several prices for the items. This will cause the material cost to vary. In other words, the material cost is a variable. Therefore, in addition to ordering costs and holding costs, we also consider material costs. This model is called the quantity discount model. How to calculate the material cost? Consider one example. A shop buys shoes from a distributor at a cost of 50 ringgit each. The annual demand for the shoes is 300. The annual material cost is equals to the annual demand 300 times the cost of each item 50 ringgit or 1500 ringgit. So in general, if the cost of each item is C, and the annual demand is D, then the material cost equals to D times C. The formula for the quantity discount model is total cost equals to material cost plus ordering cost plus holding cost, where material cost is D times C, ordering cost is D over Q times C sub O, and holding cost is Q over 2 times C sub H. EOQ is still square root of 2D C sub O over C sub H.
I will discuss one example from the book by Brenda Stare and Hannah about the brass department store.
Brass department store orders toy race cars. The ordering cost is $49 per order. The annual demand is 5,000 race cars. Holding cost is 20% of the cost of items. When the store orders the items, the price of each item depends on a discount schedule. If it orders between 0 to 999 items, there is no discount and the price of each item is $5. If it orders between 1,000 to 1,999 items, there is a 4% discount and the price of each item is $4.80. If it orders 2,000 and over, there is a 5% discount and the price of each item is $4.75.
The cost of ordering is $49. The annual demand is 5,000, and the holding cost is 20% of the cost of items, or 0.20C. The formula for EOQ is given by square root of 2D C sub O over C sub H. D is 5,000, C sub O is $49, and C sub H is 0.20 times C. However, there are three values of C: $5, $4.80, and $4.75. Since there are three values of C, and CH depends on C, therefore we have to find three values of EOQ. Consider when the cost of item is $5. The EOQ equals to square root of 2D C sub O divided by C sub H. C sub H is 0.20 times C, which is $5, equals to 700. It means that the cost is lowest at 700. However, if we want to get this price, we must order between 0 to 999. Or on this graph, it is between 0 to 999. Since 700 is within this interval, so we can accept the value of 700. So the adjusted OQ is 700. Consider when the cost is $4.80. The EOQ equals to square root of 2 times 5,000 times 49 divided by CH, which is 0.20 times C, and C is 480, equals to 714. It means that the cost is lowest at 714. But if we want to get this price, we must order between 1,000 to 1,999. Or on this graph, between 1,000 to 1,999. 714 is not in this interval, so therefore we cannot accept 714. From this graph, the cost is lowest at 1,000. So therefore, the adjusted EOQ equals to 1,000. Now consider when the cost is 475. The EOQ equals to square root of 2 times 5,000 times 49 divided by CH, which is 0.20 times C, which is 475, equals to 718. It means that the cost is lowest at 718. But if you want to get this price, we should order 2,000 and over. On this graph,
this is 2000 and over. Now 718 is not in this interval, so we cannot accept 718. From this graph, the graph is lowest at 2000. Therefore, the adjusted EOQ is equals to 2000. Consider the first case where cost is $5 and the adjusted EOQ is 700. We calculate the three costs. The first cost is the material cost. The formula is D times C equals to 5,000 times the cost of item is $5, which is 25,000. The next cost is the ordering cost. The formula is D over Q times C sub O equals to 5,000 times the order quantity is 700 times the ordering cost is 49 equals to 350. The third cost is the holding cost. The formula equals to Q over 2 times C sub H. Q is the order quantity, 700, divided by 2 times C sub H. But C sub H is 0.20 times C. C is the cost, which is $5, equals to 350. Then we get the total cost equals to 25,700. Now consider the second case where the cost is $4.80 and the adjusted EOQ equals to 1,000. The material cost equals to 5,000 times 480 equals to 24,000. The ordering cost equals to 5,000 divided by 1,000 times the cost of ordering, 49,245. The holding cost equals to 1,000 over 2 times CH, which is 0.2 times the cost of item, 480. Equals to 480. So the total cost equals to 24,725 dollars. Finally, consider the third case where the cost of item is 475 and the adjusted EOQ equals to 2,000. The material cost equals to 5,000 times 475 equals to 23,750. Ordering cost equals to 5,000 over 2,000 times the cost of ordering, which is 49, equals to $122.50. Holding cost equals to 2,000 over 2 times CH, which is 0.2 times the cost of item, 475. This equals to 950. The total cost equals to 24,822 dollars and 50 cents. If we summarize the results, we get the following table. We can either order 700, 1000 or 2000, and these are the total costs for each amount that we order. If we compare these three total costs, the smallest is 24,725 when we order 1000. So that is how much we should order. We should order 1000.